All right, so we are putting together a queen size bed that I got from Amazon. Just so y'all know that this was not easy. It took me a couple of days. You see all of these pieces. There's a lot of pieces here, and a lot of them aren't even numbered. So, let's go. Okay, so we're going to start with the fact that, like I said, there was a lot of pieces here, and the instructions, you're going to see me looking at those several times because, y'all, there were no actual written instructions. It was all pictures and numbers, and like I said, a lot of them, the pieces weren't even numbered, but we made it work. So we're going to get the screws, and the reason why I'm looking at it like several times here is because the way that it wants that it looks, it wants me to have this piece in a certain way, then it looks like it doesn't make any sense. So I was trying to make some sense of it, but it really didn't make much sense. As you guys know, I always find a lesson in everything that I do, so I'm going to teach y'all a little something that I learned in this process. So a couple of things that I learned, I'm going to start with one. One is always go with your gut. Always go with your gut, because if something doesn't make sense, then 9 times out of 10 it really doesn't. So if you, like, a lot of times, like during this process here, like I'm looking at things and I'm like, this doesn't really make any sense. Like the way that I'm putting this on, it wasn't really fitting the way that I thought it was supposed to, and I'm like, this can't be right, this doesn't make any sense. So if you're looking at things over and over again and it's just like not making sense, then just go with what you feel makes more sense, because at the end of the day, you trust your gut. It's more than likely right most of the time. Another thing that I learned doing this is to always go back to the manual. So for those of you who may or may not know me very well, I'm a Jesus baby, as some people call, people say. So I've learned, I am still learning, that sometimes you're going to read, like when you read your word and you read your Bible, sometimes it may not make sense to you. Some things just don't necessarily look like I don't understand it, I don't get this. But if you keep going back and you keep reading it and asking God for guidance, He will absolutely, you know, show you exactly what it is that it means. And especially what it means when it applies to, you know, when you apply it to your everyday life. Because as you can see, I'm going back to the source. You know what I mean? I'm going back to the source. I'm going back to the manual several times because I just want to make sure, like, am I seeing this right? Am I hearing this correctly? Sometimes I'm misinterpreting, and sometimes I'm just, you know, I get something different. And in this case here, it was a bit frustrating. This was a trial that I ended up having to go through, and when I tell you, this part here was so frustrating because it wouldn't fit the way that I wanted it to, the screw pretty much, and I got discouraged. I'm not even gonna lie, I got very discouraged to the point where I was like, you know what, I'm just going to have to let this go for a minute because this is not working. So I'm going every which way, getting frustrated. And instead of, you know, being frustrated for the whole time,
all kinds,
I think it's time to just chill for a minute.
A little bit of a look and watch and see how.
progress done. It started to become a little easier. The instructions are starting to make a little bit more sense. A little bit, not too much. But we're getting it done. Final